Very good morning to you all. I am Dr. Subbarai, Professor, Head IQSE, Coordinator NAC, Shadan College of Engineering and Technology, Hyderabad, Telangana State. Our college is organizing, IQSE is organizing 2 weeks faculty development program on NAC assessment and accreditation. Today is the seventh day, seventh session. Today's session, we are going to read the manual, understand the NAC manual completely and carefully. So that is the main objective of the topic program schedule. Today, criteria 4, which is dealing with infrastructure and the learning resources, nothing but the library. Of course, once again, I am recollecting the objective of the FDP. Main objective is read the manual completely. For qualitative metrics and quantitative metrics, we have to go through the manual. We have to understand the, read the data template, how we have to present the data as per the NAC requirement. And above all, for quantitative metrics, in each criteria, in each key indicator, quantitative metrics, our response should be in number. This much percentage we achieved, likewise. Qualitative metrics, it is a descriptive answer. The reason I am often recollecting same message every day, there may be a newcomer. Otherwise, the main understanding for the teachers, those who are involving in SSR, this is a key message. That's the reason I am insisting often. On behalf of our chairman, Mr. Shah Alam Rasul Khan, Chairman, Sadan Educational Society, and Honorable Principal Dr. Muhammad Atikur Raghuman, Co-Coordinator Dr. Afroz Magar, Dr. Subramaniam, on behalf of all the IQSE members, professors, directors of Sadan College of Engineering and Technology, once again, I welcome you all. We are moving towards criteria 4. Criterion 4, infrastructure and learning resources. The key indicator 4.1, physical facilities of the institution, which is having 30 weightage. Criteria 4, total weightage is 100. Metric number 4.1.1 is a qualitative metrics, weightage is 5. So our answer should be maximum of 500 words. Here we have to show the proof about institutions, infrastructure and physical facilities for teaching and learning. Classroom facilities we have to show, laboratories facilities we have to show, computing equipments we have to show as per the minimum specified requirement by the statutory bodies. Of course, very clear, open explanation, what are all the physical resources available in your institution, that has to be presented systematically. Next, metric number 4.1.2 is also qualitative metric, so our answer should be descriptive. It is a 5 weightage. The institutions having facilities for cultural activity, that is infrastructure, sports, games, indoor, outdoor, gymnasium, all the details, all the institution must have. So that information you are going to present in a systematic way, including yoga, facilities for the yoga, how best the organization having infrastructure, including the specification, area, size, year of establishment, user rate, that is a very important point. Dear professors, dear teachers, see, having infrastructure is not the matter. You must have the infrastructure as well as utilization. that is real resource usage. The resources should not be in ideal condition. For example, the next key indicator, we are going to see library also. Library, how many faculty members every day accessing the library? How many students are accessing the library? That evidence we have to prove, we have to show as per the NAC requirement. So utilization is a key factor. So this also a qualitative metric. So answer should be descriptive. Next, metric number 4.1.3. It is a quantitative metric. So our response should be in number. See the formula. What is the question here? Percentage of classrooms and the seminar halls with the ICT enabled facilities such as smart class learning management system. So this definition we have to clearly understand. So for that, if it is a quantitative metrics, we have to refer three places. One is manual, another one is a data template integrated with the manual, another one is the standard operating procedure, that is how your supportive document should be. If you have your own understanding, if it is beyond the boundary of the NAC manual, standard operating procedure, the data will not be considered for calculation purpose. So this message we have to keep it in our mind. So what is the major questions here? Read the manual carefully. Number of classrooms and seminar halls with the ICT facilities. So this is a question. Data template, number of classroom with ICT facilities, that is LCD facilities. Number of classroom with Wi-Fi, LAN facilities. Number of smart classroom, we have to include. The number of classroom with learning management system, that we have to understand, we have to write. Number of seminar halls with ICT facility. Seminar halls with ICT facility. So how our answer should be? We have to read the data template, which is available in the manual. Number of classroom and seminar halls with ICT facility to total number of classroom and seminar halls into 100. So this is the key question. Now refer the standard operating procedure for 4.1.3. What are all the supportive document, additional information we have to upload? Geotagged photographs of the ICT enabled classroom seminar halls with captions we have to submit. Dear professors, only classrooms and seminar halls with ICT enabled facility to be considered here. Only classroom, lab and workshop with ICT facility not to be considered. Sometimes one or two institution may have the laboratory. The laboratory equipped with the ICT facility, workshop equipped with the ICT facility, that will not be considered for calculation purpose in the metric number 4.1.3 as per the NAC manual as well as per the standard operating procedure. Next, we are moving towards metric number 4.1.4. This also quantitative metrics. See, expenditure for infrastructure, this is the question. Very careful information. Dear professors, those who are involving in NAC SSR preparation, they have to have close interaction with the accounts department for audit statement. So for that, we teachers, those who are preparing SSR, only explain in detail about the standard operating procedure to the accounts department, because this is very careful. So what are all the information? This is a 5 years data, last 5 years data we have to provide. Average expenditure, average percentage of expenditure, excluding salary for infrastructure augmentation during the last 5 years data. So what is the question here? Expenditure for infrastructure augmentation excluding salary to total expenditure excluding salary. So this is the key formula. This calculation we have to submit for 5 years. 5 years as per the data template, read the manual carefully. Now coming to standard operating procedure for metric 4.1.4. So here, what are the additional document we have to submit? Provide the consolidated fund allocation towards infrastructure augmentation facilities duly certified by finance officer. So this is the key points. It should be certified by finance officer, highlighting the relevant items in the audited income and expenditure statement. Read the SOP carefully. This metric 4.1.4 is supposed to be looked at with the perspective of infrastructure augmentation only. So that is the key point, infrastructure augmentation. So for that, carefully we have to calculate the figure, how the document should be. In case of privately funded higher education institution, the document should be certified by chartered accountant. The accounts department, they know very clearly. And what are all the item will not be considered here as per 4.1.4. Please listen. Avoid recurring expenditure on laboratory, maintenance of infrastructure, and acquisition of books, journals under this matrix. Read the SOP carefully. What is mean by recurring expenses? Recurring expenses are those expenses which are incurred by a business on a regular basis. The amount will be spent on regular basis in a business. That is called recurring expenses. The recurring expenses has to be avoided in this calculation purpose. So this is purely based on infrastructure augmentation. It is 10 weightage. Next, moving towards key indicator 4.2, library as a learning resources, 20 points. So the document should be very carefully. Before that, we have to understand the utilization of the library resources. So 4.2.1. So the involvement of the librarians, chief librarian of your institution will play a major role in 4.2. Which institution applying for first time applying for cycle 1 NAC accreditation, please assign this duty of 4.2 along with the faculty team, involve chief librarian and department librarian in charge. So what is the main question? Library is automated using integrated library management system, ILMS. Of course, all the institution, all the faculty member, they know. This is 4 weightage. Data requirement, last 5 years data we have to submit. Upload a description of library with the name of the integrated library management system, name of automation, fully partial version, year of automation. Happily, we are conveying in this occasion our management. Yes, of course, we have these facilities. Management has invested huge amount in library management in our organization. Next, we are moving towards 4.1.2. The institution has subscription for the following e-resources. What are all the e-resources your institution is having? This very carefully we have to understand. See the answer. Your response should be either A or B or C or D or E. So they have given 5 options. How you have to choose the answer as per the question. So they are asking, they are checking the whether the institution is having the following 6 items in your organization or not, in your library or not. Number 1, e-journals, e-Sot Sindhu, Sot Ganga membership, e-books, databases, remote access to e-resources. So they are asking availability of the 6 major resources, e-resources. For example, some institution may have all the 6 items. So you can choose option A. That is, any institution having any four or more of the above means you can choose the answer A. Correspondingly, you have to refer either A, B, C, D, E. E means none of the above. Of course, that is not possible. So you have to choose the responses accordingly, because this is a quantitative matrix. So refer data template. So 4.2.2, read the data template carefully. This is our guide. So what is a supportive document? You have to submit e copy of the letter of subscription membership in the name of higher education institution should be submitted as an additional information. Screenshot of the facilities claimed with the name of higher education institution we have to submit. Specific details in respect of e-resources selected we can submit. We have to ensure that the letter of subscription contains complete details we have to submit. During the data verification validation, we have to provide link in the institutional verification for selected option for the DVV partner verification. So we have to provide the resource link in our college website. The DVV partner, they will select the resource availability in your organization. What are all the item will not be considered for calculation purpose as per 4.2.2? Dear professor, soft copy of the printed books cannot be accepted as a e-book. Please carefully understand the word standard operating procedure. So as per the detail, if you have submitting supportive document, data template and standard operating procedure, we can score full marks. Otherwise, we have to create these resources. Next, 4.2.3. This is related with the budget details. What is the question here? 4.3.3. Average annual expenditure for purchase of books, e-books. So this is last 5 years data. This is a quantitative metrics. Average annual expenditure for books and e-books and subscription of journals and e-journals. This is for 5 years data we have to submit. So how much amount your institution is spending on books, e-books, journals, e-journals for the past 5 years? This is data template. The data template available in the manual. So your data requirement, expenditure on the purchase of the e-book, how much? Expenditure on the purchase of the journals, e-journal in the first year and the year of expenditure. So we have to use this formula. According to the formula, you will get the figure. Carefully read, substitute the value from your accounts department details. Discuss with our authority, those who are involving in this budget financial matter. If we substitute the corresponding figure, we can get the response. That response is the right answer. So what is the data standard operating procedure expectations for this corresponding data 4.2.3? In the 4.2.3, provide consolidated extract of expenditure for purchase of books and the journals during the last 5 years, duly attested by head of the institution and chartered accountant. That data we have to submit. Audited income expenditure statement highlighting the expenditure for purchase of the books and the journals. This is a strong evidence proof as per the metric number 4.2.3. We have to submit for full scoring of marks. Next, we are moving towards next metric number 4.2.4. This is also a quantitative metric. Our answer should be as per the formula. Percentage per day usage of library by teachers and students. Usage of library dear professors, earlier I told we may have huge resources in our college, but the question is how best that resources are being utilized by the stakeholders. That will be verified. Accordingly, the value, that is mark, will be given to the institution resources. That is footfalls and login data for online access, we have to show as the evidence. Data for the latest completed academic year, we have to show. Resource availability, how much amount we spent, and how many faculty members are utilizing, whether the data for the current academic year or latest completed academic year or last 5 years. So it should be carefully understand by the NAC team of your institution. So upload the, what are all the evidence we have to show? Simply they will not accept. So 4.2.4, how much, what is the evidence? Certified e-copy of the ledger for footfalls for 5 days, we have to submit as the evidence. Certified screenshots of the data for the same 5 days for online access, we have to show as the evidence. And also, after submitting all our SSR during the DVV, data verification and validation, the DVV partner may ask the higher education institution to submit the randomly selected details. Randomly selected 5 days will be served by the DVV partner. So according to requirement, our data should be clearly maintained and we have to upload in the SSR format. So formula, we have the formula. This is a correct response. Number of teachers and students using library per day. Total number of teachers and students. For example, in your institution, total number of teachers and students 100. Example, I am telling. Only 12 faculty members, including students, are accessing. Otherwise, 80 faculty members and students put together accessing your library resources means you have to submit the corresponding data in the formula. You will get the answer. That will be the right answer. Along with that, we have to show the evidence as per the requirement of the standard operating procedure and the data template. Now, key indicator 4.3, that is IT infrastructure. So we have to show the evidence of infrastructure facilities which is available in your organization. That is called qualitative metrics 4.3.1. Qualitative metrics is nothing but the descriptive answer, not more than 500 words. The institution frequently updates its IT facilities, including Wi-Fi. So this is a question. So no need to teach something to the NAC. We have to explain. We have to show the evidence for this question. We have to describe about the IT facilities, including Wi-Fi, with the date and nature of updation with a maximum of 500 words. So this is a very simple direct question. We can easily understand. This is 5%, 5 marks. Next question, 4.3.2. It is a quantitative metric. So our answer should be in number. Student computer ratio. Carefully, we must know how. Data for the latest completed academic year. Which is latest completed academic year? For example, today, 14th July, now we started new academic year, that is current academic year or ongoing academic year. Latest academic year, 2019-20. For that period, corresponding student computer ratio, we have to upload here. Number of students, number of computers, we have to include in the corresponding calculation. So for this, we have to verify the 4.3.2 standard operating procedure. Dear professors, we know that we have enough computer facilities, but which are all the resources will not be counted for this question as per standard operating procedure? The computers for office and faculty use will not be considered. Make a note. Computers purchased after the latest completed academic year not to be considered. So this is the main point, we have to keep it in our mind. Next, 4.3.3, bandwidth of internet connection in the institution. Of course, this is a direct question, no need of much explanation. This is a quantitative metrics, 15 marks weightage. So how your evidence should be as per the standard operating procedure? Bills for any 1 month or one quarter of the latest completed academic year indicating internet connection plan, speed and bandwidth, and the higher education institution name. It should be shown as the evidence or additional information. E-copy of document of agreement with the service provider. Agreement the institution made with the service provider, the corresponding e-copy should be shown as the evidence. Only leased line connectivity in the name of higher education institution will be considered. Please make a note. Which are the data will not be considered for the metric 4.3.3? Please read carefully, read the standard operating procedure carefully. Snapshot of speed test for Wi-Fi internet facility will not be considered. Next, broadband connection will not be considered. So we have to be very carefully to score the highest ranking, highest score in NAC. What is the actual expectation by the NAC authority? There we have to be very careful. Next, we are moving towards last key indicator of criteria 4. Of course, within 5 minutes we can complete the session. Key indicator 4.4, maintenance of campus infrastructure. It is a 20 marks weightage, total key indicator. So what is the question here? See, the metric number 4.4.1 is a quantitative matrix. Our answer should be in number. What is the question here? Average percentage of expenditure incurred on maintenance. Expenditure on maintenance. You have resources. How often we are maintaining and what is the corresponding cost involved? Infrastructure, physical and academic support facilities, excluding salary. So this is the key point. So this information we have to collect from the institution accounts department, but the faculty member, those who are involving in NAC preparation document, we must have closer discussion with the accounts department. We have to make them to understand accordingly. We have to prepare the statement, the component during the last 5 years data. So this is the 5 years data. Amount should be in lakhs. So we have to verify the data template. Read the data template carefully. Non-salary expenditure incurred. So that is a key point. Then expenditure incurred on maintenance of campus infrastructure. Only maintenance of campus infrastructure will be shown, will be considered for this calculation. So we have to use the corresponding formula. Then what will be the figure we will get? That should be written in the response column in the corresponding metric number. Percentage per year. Expenditure on maintenance of physical and academic support facilities excluding salary component. Two, total expenditure excluding salary component. This data for the past 5 years. So 4.4.1 for this, what is the explanation from standard operating procedure? We have to provide the audited income and the expenditure statement highlighting the item of expenditure incurred on maintenance of physical facilities and academic support facilities duly certified by head of the institution and chartered accountant. So how the evidence should be? Next, focus of this metric is only on the maintenance of physical and academic support facilities. We should not have our own understanding. Read the document carefully. Mere statement of last 5 years data on the metric without audited statement will not be considered during the DVV verification. So submit the document very carefully as per the standard operating procedure. Then last point of today's session, last point of criteria 4 is 4.4.2. It is a qualitative matrix, that is descriptive answer. There are established system and procedure for maintaining and utilizing physical, academic and support facilities, laboratory, library, sports complex, computers, classroom. This is a expectations from the NAC. So how the answer should be? We have to describe policy details, procedures. Here again, we can use the word standard operating procedure. How the system is having for maintenance. So this answer, we can relate with the criteria 6, that is a decentralization, organizational chart, organogram, leadership and governance of the institution that we are going to discuss in the 9th session. At that time, we will relate how decentralized responsibility and authority you have given in your organization. Even we can discuss in criteria 7, we can relate this answer with criteria 7, distinctiveness or best practices. The best practices even for academic maintenance infrastructure, anyway, we can give. So what is the policy details? What is the incremental improvement your institution is showing because of this decentralization and the corresponding system procedure you are having? So for that, we have to have a policy details, utilizing physical, academic and the support facilities on the website within the maximum of 1,000 words. Here, 1,000 words. So this is the expectation from the NAC. We have to show the additional information. So today we are completing our session, 7th session on criteria 4 up to 4.4.2 qualitative matrix. So we have discussed about requirement of the infrastructure from that is a classroom, seminar hall, ICT facility, Wi-Fi, LAN facility and library resources, corresponding utilization, budget on maintenance and purchase of books, journals, how the institution is having a procedure for maintenance and audited statement for various places we have discussed, we have seen. So for quantitative metrics, as per the manual, refer the data template and the standard operating procedure. Carefully, we have to write the data, fill the data, show the additional document for maximum marks. Thank you very much.